بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إن شاء الله I'll be talking about the invalidators of wudu ablution, which means if any of the following matters occur, the person would have to make wudu again prior to performing the prayer. The first among the invalidators of wudu is the emission of anything from the inflammatory outlets, such as urine, gas, feces, or blood, except for mani. Mani is the sexual spermal fluid of the man and the corresponding sexual fluid of the woman. Now, the emission of mani by itself does not invalidate ablution, but it makes the purificatory bath, the ghusl, obligatory. So, if the man or the female emitted mani, this person would have to perform the purificatory bath ghusl first before praying. I spoke about performing the ghusl in another video. The second matter is touching the penis, vagina, or anus of a human with the inside part of the bare hand. The inside part of the hand is the area of the hand which does not show when one places one's hands together, palm to palm, with fingers spread and applying a slight pressure. So touching the penis, vagina, or anus with the back of the hand does not invalidate one's ablution. Likewise, touching these areas with a barrier between the hand and the organ does not invalidate the ablution either. The third matter is the touching of the male, the skin of the marriageable woman, when both have attained to an age at which they are normally desired. So touching the skin of the woman whom one cannot marry in any case, such as one's sister, mother, aunt, or mother-in-law, does not invalidate ablution either. The fourth matter is losing sanity or consciousness, except if one is sleeping with one's buttocks firmly seated in such a way that one is certain one does not pass gas, and one wakes up in the same position in which one sleeps. Feel free to leave me a comment on the bottom if you have a question pertaining to today's lesson.